So now in Surah Al-Hajj 22-26 verse, وَإِذْبَوَّعْنَا لِإِبْرَاهِيمَ مَكَانَ الْبَيْتِ أَلَّا تُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا وَطَّهِّرْ بَيْتِيَ لِلطَّائِفِينَ وَالْقَائِمِينَ وَالرُّكَّعِ السُّجُودِ. And we pointed out the place of house for Ibrahim, that you do not associate anything with me, and purify my house for those who go round, who stand and bow prostrate. Now, for Ibrahim al-Islam, Allah pointed out the place of the house. The house was there. House was there. He was pointed out, like I point, that is the house, that is the place. So we pointed out the place of house to Ibrahim al-Islam. What? Allah tushrik bi shayya, that you do not associate anything with me. Now these are the principles of that house. The now is physical house we know, now the psychological house is coming. Do not associate anything with me. First, wa tahir baytiya, and purify my house. Now Allah is referring to that house as my house. Lit taifina, those who are going round, wal qaimina, those who are standing, wal rukka sujood, who are doing bowing and prostrating. And for the house, Allah says that do not associate anyone with me. First rule, principle, foundation. The second is that to purify my house. Purify means tahir baytiya, purify my house. Lit taifina, for those who are going round. Now this act was done at that time when Ibrahim al-Islam was pointed out. That means the salah, the prayer was established before, and the tawaf or the going around the Kaaba was before. So Ibrahim is pointed out that do not associate anyone with me, and purify my house for those who are going around, who are standing and bowing and prostrating. Standing, bowing and prostrating, you purify my house for those. Like for example, people are doing tawaf there, people are establishing the salah that they're standing and bowing and prostrating. People are visiting the sacred mosque from all parts of the world. And they are standing, bowing, prostrating, and at the same time, they are doing tawaf. Now Allah says to Ibrahim, you purify for them, for these people who are doing tawaf, being going around, and who are standing, bowing and prostrating. You have to purify the house, my house, for them. How would you purify the house of Allah for them? Physically, if you go there, all the time people are washing and cleaning the house. Physically, practice by is there. But for Ibrahim al-Islam, Allah say, you purify my house for those who are standing, who are doing tawaf, going around, standing, bowing, prostrating. How would you purify? That means in their mind. What is the concept in their mind? You have to purify that. Because people are standing, bowing and prostrating, that means they are establishing the salah, the prayer. And they are going around the Kaaba. That is all being established. But the concept of the house is not purified in their minds. The concept of the house is not purified in their minds. So you have to purify for them. What is the concept of the house today in people's minds? Today, people believe or have that ideology, concept, there were 360 idols or stones in the house of God. You believe that. How would you purify? You believe this is the second direction of belief. First direction of belief was Beit al-Maqdis, meaning Jerusalem. This is the concept being prevailed. So you have got this mind in your mind. So you have to purify, Allah says to Ibrahim, to purify my house. From ancient time, the salah is there. From ancient time I'm talking, the salah was there. They were establishing the salah, the prayer, and the tawaf was going on. But the minds of the people from that time till today is corrupted, that they think in various means. Some people do not believe the physical house at all. And at the same time, some people say that there was 360 gods in the house of God. idols, physical idols. So that is purification. You have to purify. There is not a single ayah in the whole book Quran which says that there were one, not 360, not even one idol in the house of God at any time. Because it says to Ibrahim al-Islam, we pointed out the place of the house for Ibrahim, that you do not associate anything with me and purify my house for those who are going around. So people are going around. Those who stand, وَالْقَائِمِينَ وَالْقَائِمِينَ, they are standing, bowing and prostrating before Ibrahim al-Islam was pointed, still the concept of Salah was there. And Tawaf was there, Hajj was there. Everything was there. But what he has to do is to purify their house for them, means purify their minds. They have got the wrong concept of the house. And same Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did it, and same we have to do it. That still today, people have got the wrong ideology of the house and the wrong idea of the concept of the house of God. So this is how you purify the house of God for those who are standing, bowing, prostrating, they establish the Salah without understanding. They are going and doing the pilgrimage without understanding. They do everything without understanding. So that is how, this is how he has to purify the house. These were the principles in Surah, further in Baqarah 2 and Ayah 127. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَعِيلُ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. And when Ibrahim and Ismail raised the foundations or principles from the house, our Lord, accept from us, surely you are hearing and knowing. In Arabic, it's يَرْفَعَ. Rafa means to raise. Qawaid means, you know, qaida. In this, when the child read this qaida, it's principles. How to read the Quran, they say, there are principles in the Quran. Read the Quran in Arabic. So the teacher says, the Maulvi Sahib says, bring the qaida. Qaida means, what is the principle to how to read the Quran? There are, you know, the principles. So the qawaid is the plural of the qaida. So they corrupted this word, al-qaida, al-qaida. Al-qaida means nothing but a principle. It's a principle. So Ibrahim al-Islam and Ismail al-Islam raised the principles from the house. House was there. He did not raise the, make the wall. He was not a, what do you say, mason. Still today people are, you know, doing this work. So are they following the Sunnah? We are not following the Sunnah of Ibrahim Islam. How can we can never become a mason there and do the house fixed right? So here you understand the raising of the foundation of the principle of the Qaeda is that do not associate anyone with me and purify my house for those who are going round, who are doing standing, bowing and prostrating. That is the principle that they raised. They purify the house for those people who were standing, who were bowing and prostrating and doing tawaf or going round. For them, he purified the house. These are the principles. These are the foundation of the house which Ibrahim alayhissalam and Ismail alayhissalam raised. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ وَإِسْمَعِيلُ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا. When Ibrahim and Ismail raised the foundation of principles from the house, they said, our Lord, accept from us. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. You are all hearing and knowing. So you understand the principles, that the principles are purify my house for those, for other people who do not know the correct concept of the house. They have corrupted the house in their mind. But they are standing, they are going, prostrating, they are stepping the Salah, they are going around the Tawaf, they are doing Tawaf, doing around. So you have to purify the house for them. So this is the principle of the Ibrahim al-Islam Ismail al-Islam raised. They did not make the wall of the house. It doesn't say. Who made the Kaaba? Ja'ala Allahul Ka'bata al-Bayta al-Haram. I read that ayat. Allah made the Kaaba. It was Allah made, and by science also now it has been proven that it is not a human-made rock. Now, when Ibrahim al-Islam was leaving, he says in Surah Ibrahim 14, he prays to Allah in Surah Ibrahim 14:37, رَبَّنَا إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ فاجعل أفئدة من الناس تهوي إليهم وارزقهم من الثمرات لعلهم يشكرون. O Lord, surely I have settled from my offsprings within the valley. Other than that, it is without cultivation near your sacred forbidden house. O our Lord, so that they may establish the Salah, then make the hearts of the people desirable towards them, and give them sustenance from the fruits, so they may be thankful. Now in this ayah, Ibrahim al-Islam is praying to Allah that I am settling from my offsprings in a valley without cultivation. That valley again is Safa Marwa. It says, Biwadin ghairi dizar in the Baitik al-Muharram, near the house. Because the location of the house is near the valley of Safa Marwa. So he says, I am settling down from my offsprings, is plural. Now they say Zuriyati is people, Ibrahim al-Islam and then Hajra, and this story comes here. Don't bring stories in the ayahs. The moment you bring the story, Zuriyati is plural. How is wife fit in? They say Hajra was and Ismail one. The Sira in Arabic is two. It's in plural. Zuriyati means plural. So he's settling down his offsprings or the descendants. I've settled from my offspring or descendants within the valley, near the valley, within the valley. Other than that, is without cultivation. That is between Safa Marwa Valley. That is valley. And he says, "Oh, our near the house, oh our Lord," that they establish the prayer. So you can see today the prayer is being established before also, and now it is also established. But the house is concept of the house purification is not there. But the establishment of Salah, prayer and Tawaf is there now, going around the Kaaba is there. So he says, O Allah, so they establish the prayer, then make the hearts of the people desirable towards them. Towards who? Who are establishing prayer and that concept? Who are having on the right concept of the house? So make other mankind desirable towards them. And give those people sustenance from the fruits so they may be thankful. So the other people who are not following the Kaaba, following the Kaaba means who do not have the right concept of the Kaaba, or people who do not know about the house of God, Allah is asking, Ibrahim al-Islam is praying that make the hearts desirable towards them who knows this. So they must have some inclination towards them. So they desire that they also go to Kaaba, visit the house, that they go around there and they see this. So I've noticed that non-Muslim people are forcing the Muslim people that you should open the gates for us and we want to see Kaaba there. Why are you stopping us? Why don't you let everybody go to Kaaba at Mecca? Mecca and Medina are two cities which are holy. No non-Muslim can enter that in their cities. So if you don't believe in this, why are you with that desire? So you can see the world has desire and they are making full pressure to the Saudi government to open the gates that we all mankind should go and visit Mecca and Medina. You cannot go there because there is ayat in the Quran which Allah said the mushrik or the associate in Surah Tawbah, do not let them come near the sacred mosque after this year. So it is stopped. It has made as a holy city, Mecca. So that is what I'm saying. So, but people have desire. So Allah is asking, Ibrahim is asking that make the people's desire for them, for these people who know. Now what is in the house? Surah Ali Imran 397. Fihi ayatum bayyinatum maqam Ibrahim. وَمَنْ دَخَلَهُ كَانَ آمِنًا وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنِ الْعَالَمِينَ. In it are clear ayahs, signs that standing position of Ibrahim, whosoever enters it becomes secure, and for Allah is the Hajj, the pilgrimage of the house over people, whosoever has the capability towards this way, and whosoever rejects, then surely Allah is not needful for the worlds. Now you will note that both things are mentioned in this ayah. First it says there are clear ayahs, signs, which is the standing of Ibrahim al-Islam, Maqam Ibrahim. What is Maqam Ibrahim? is declared of ayahs. The whenever the ayahs, first spiritual aspect of the ayat is, whenever the ayat understanding is clarified, that is the standing of Ibrahim al-Islam in the house. That is the standing position or the honor status or standard status or honor of Maqam Ibrahim al-Islam. Fihi ayatum bayinat. Whenever the ayahs are clarified, so the honor is Maqam Ibrahim, standing position of Ibrahim in the house. That's a psychological understanding. The moment you understand an ayah clarified to you, it becomes the Maqamu Ibrahim. That is the standing position of Ibrahim. That is the honor. So it is a very honorable thing for any one of us who understands the ayahs are clarified, that is the Maqam Ibrahim, standing position of Ibrahim in the house. وَمَنْ دَخَلَوْ كَانَ آمِنًا. And you will enter in it and you will get security. When? The eyes are cleared. When the eyes are cleared, you will enter in security. That is the psychological understanding. But physically also, if you go there, where the Imam, because Ibrahim al-Islam is also Imam, the leader. So the Imam where he stands is the standing position of Ibrahim. Again, that all the mankind, when we go there and pray, the Imam is leading the prayer. Where he stands to pray is the standing position of Ibrahim, because Ibrahim al-Islam is the Imam or the leader for all mankind in the house. So that again, that is also physically, if you go and see, the Imam is there standing and the people are praying, standing, bowing and prostrating. That is the physical position, honor as a leader in the house of Allah. وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حَجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. This is a conditional ayat that whoever has the capability towards his way to go to Mecca, he should go. It's a, for Hajj he must go. For Hajj he must go if he has got the capability. It's a conditional. Not everybody has to go to Hajj. If he has got the capability towards his way, it says, whoso enters because of it, and for Allah is the pilgrimage Hajj of the house over the people, whosoever has the capability towards his way. Not everyone has the capability, physical strength, psychological strength, wealth strength, everything included. If you are physically healthy, psychologically healthy, and financially healthy, if you have the capability to go to Hajj, you must go to Hajj, not once, every time, every year. It doesn't say you go once. The ayah doesn't say once. If you've got in every year, if you've got the ability, you must go every year. But now the governments are making restrictions, that's a separate issue. But what Allah says, وَلِلَّهِ النَّاسِ حَجُّ الْمَنِ اسْتَطَعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. And for Allah is the pilgrimage of the house over the people, whosoever has the capability towards the way, who he must go. Whosoever rejects, then surely Allah is not needful for the worlds, from the worlds. In Baqarah 2:125, it says, وَإِذْ جَعَلْنَا الْبَيْتَ مَثَابَةً لِلنَّاسِ وَأَمْنًا وَاتَّخِذُوا مِن مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ مُصَلًّى وَعَهِدْنَا إِلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ أَنْ طَيِّرَا بَيْتَ لِلطَّائِفِينَ وَالْعَاكِفِينَ وَرُكَّعِ السُّجُودِ. And we made the house a place of reward and security for people, and you take the place of salah, prayer, from the standing of Ibrahim or standing position of Ibrahim. We covenanted towards Ibrahim and Ismail that purify my house for those who go around and use as itikaf for retreat or and who bow prostrate. Now Allah says in this ayah that we have made the house as a place of reward and secure. And the half, how we will say half, we have to bring salah from there. It says here, وَاتَّخِذُوا مِن مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ مُصَلَّى. That you take the prayer from the standing position, from the standing position of the place of prayer of Ibrahim al-Islam. Wherever he stands to pray, that is the standing position of Ibrahim al-Islam as an imam. So you say, وَاتَّخِذُوا مِن مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ مُصَلَّى. You take from the standing position of Ibrahim the place of prayer. One, we have to take the physical prayer. And once you know that the ayahs are clear to you, then you must recite those ayahs in your namaz, in prayer. You see, from the childhood we have been practicing, we are reciting certain verses which we were taught in the childhood. Once you understand any ayah, its clarification is to you. Or if you are in a specific position or situation, you have to memorize those ayat with understanding, because it's clarified to you. Then you repeat those ayah portions of ayat in your prayer, because you have to read from the standing position of Ibrahim. You have to take your salah. And what is Maqam Ibrahim? Fihi ayatum bayinat Maqam Ibrahim. The clear ayahs is the standing position of Ibrahim. The clear ayahs. So when are you taking salah from that place? You have to establish the salah reciting those verses which are clarified to you. Which are clarified to you. You must try to recite those ayahs which are clarified to you so that you control your psyche. The purpose is to take guidance. So this promise, the promise or covenant was taken between Ibrahim al-Islam or Ismail al-Islam to purify the house. وَعَهِدْنَا إِلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ أَنْ طَهِرَا بَيْتِيَا لِلطَّائِفِينَ وَالْعَاكِفِينَ وَالرُّكْعِ السُّجُودِ. Again the principles are there, that you purify my house to both Ibrahim al-Islam and Ismail al-Islam. Both, to both of them it is said that you purify my house for those who are doing tawaf, going around the Kaaba, and who are bowing and prostrating. Now, this is again, they did it. Who? Ibrahim al-Islam, Ismail al-Islam. And now, then further Muhammad Salah, then we. This is a continuous cycle, that the house is there, the standing position is there, the Salah is there. That is the Shatr al-Masjid al-Haram, the half is of the sacred mosque is the Salah. You have to take the Salah from there, Muqam Ibrahim Musalla. So you have to take the standing from the standing position, the Salah, your Salah. And you have to recite yourself the clear eyes. The clear eyes which are clear to you. You have to memorize those in Arabic with understanding, and then you bow and prostrate on those ayahs. Now in Al-Baqarah 2:152, in general Allah says, وَمِنْ حَيْثُ خَرَجْتَ فَوَلِّي وَجْهَكَ شَطْرَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ وَحَيْثُ مَا كُنْتُمْ فَوَلُّوا وُجُوهَكُمْ شَطْرَ لِيَلَّا يَكُونَ لِلنَّاسِ عَلَيْكُمْ حُجَّةٌ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْهُمْ فَلَا تَخْشَوْهُمْ وَاخْشَوْنِي وَلِيُتِمَّ نِعْمَتِي عَلَيْكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ. And from wherever you come, so revert yourself to the intersection portion, half of the sacred mosque. And wherever you are, so revert yourself to its intersection portion half, so that there would be no dispute over you from the people, except those who are oppressors from them. So fear them not, but fear me, and that I may complete my favors on you, and that you may be guided. Now this ayah is referring to all mankind in all times. Mankind in plural, believers, when they are coming from another faith, he says, wherever you come out from, meaning wherever you come out from, you revert yourself to the intersection half of the sacred mosque, and that is our Qibla, direction of belief. Direction of belief, that is our Qibla. From wherever you come, you revert yourself to the intersection half of the sacred mosque. Now, why is Allah emphasizing? Because there are people who are against that sacred mosque and system. So this is a لِيَلَّا يَكُونَ لِلنَّاسِ عَلَيْكُمْ حُجَّةٌ, so that there would be no dispute over you from the people. Meaning you have provided them the basic concept of the ayahs of the وَاتَّقِدُ مِنْ مَقَامِ الْمُسَلَّىٰ, that it is a half of the sacred mosque. So there will be no ground of dispute for them, because you are showing in the ayat. Ask them where you get the salah, the prayer, half. Where? So they may say from books of history, so tradition or hadith. So the question, big question remained, when he did not wrote the book, when he was in Bukhara in Russia, was he practicing the salah, the prayer? Was he? Of course. So how the prayer went so far off? So prayer established before Ibrahim al-Islam. The tawaf or hajj established before Ibrahim al-Islam in the Quran. It never changed. It is there as it is. So Allah says there would be no dispute, except the people who are oppressors, they may dispute. But you have put forward your argument. Allah says, wherever you are, so revert yourself to its intersection half, there would be no dispute over you from the people, except those who are oppressors from them. Except those people who are oppressors, they may dispute. But you have provided that this is how I establish the prayer, because I am establishing the my direction of belief. My Qibla is the half of the sacred mosque. Wherever in the whole world the believers or Muslims are, they have established this mosque, which is a Shatral Masjid Haram, which is the half of the sacred mosque, and they establish the Salat of prayer. But the prayer, they may not be establishing the same way it is established there. So again, Allah says, you have to purify my house for them who are standing, going prostrating and doing, going around the Kaaba. The concept is not clear, but the system is prevailing. The concept is there. The system is prevailed, the system is established. The people are establishing the Salah from before Ibrahim Islam. It was there. The Qibla direction of belief was there. But the concept of the house is not clear still today. So it says, accept those who oppress them. So fear them not, but fear me, and that I may complete my favors on you, and then you may be guided. So Allah says that He will be, if you believe that, you become the half of the sacred mosque, establish the Salat, the prayer, reciting those ayat which are clear to you, memorizing them and reciting those ayat, that is your direction of belief, and that is Shatral Masjid Haram. So Allah says, I may complete my favors on you, and that you may be guided. That means they are not guided. And further, they are, do not fear them. Do not fear them. It says, do not fear them. فَلَا تَقْشَوْهُمْ وَقْشَوْهُمْ. Do not fear them, but fear me. If you fear Allah, so you know from where the half of this, what is the half of the shirk? The whole world, I'm telling you, believe me, I'm not lying to you. You look up any Quran in the translation, no one has written Shatral Masjid Haram. No one. So when I saw this, I was afraid. But when I read this ayat, do not fear them, fear me. It's a very huge task. The whole mankind of the scholars are writing, Shatral means ilah, towards, and I took the, and wrote it, Shatral means half. They know Arabic. The Jew Arab knows it, the Christian Arab knows it, the atheist Arab knows it, Shatral means half. And they say, Atulu Shatral Iman. It's a half of the Iman, the Hissa, part. So what is the part of the sacred mosque? Salah. Allah is saying, وَاتَّقِدُوا مِن مَقَامِ إِبْرَهِيمُ وَصَلَّىٰ. You take your salah from the standing position of Ibrahim. So it is there. But it says, do not fear them, but fear me. And then it says, I will complete my favors on you, that you may be guided.